13 to 453, appreciation.
Okay. I saw another hand.
It was pretty easy.
17 on 13.2. And Chantel, I saw your hand.
13.1, just one of the, just let's just do that. One is for me.
Okay, Logan?
Mine was one of the ones from 13.1 as well. It was number three that I wanted.
Number three, so I'll just do number three.
Okay.
And you guys can take it from there. Oma, that's something for you. Here's one as well, but I would like it back. Thank you. Alright. Okay. So, yeah, guess who didn't bring her book today? This girl.
I have papers.
Yay, I'll take them. I'll start with that, thank you, love. That's all I need for this one. Alright, so I'm gonna do number three. Good morning. DJ, I have your test. Oma has the key, so just grab it from him when he's done. The picture thingies?
Yeah.
It's alright, I can help you. Alright. So let's do number three. This is 13.1, number three. So my function is 9 minus x squared, and we're going from x equals 1 to x equals 3 in four subintervals. Okay. So we're doing a right-hand side estimate. Awesome. So the way that I do this, surprisingly, I don't draw the function at all. Why? I low-key don't need it, that's right. So I am going from 1 to 3. And I'm gonna break it into four chunks. So if I break it into 2, what's this number become?
2.5.
It's halfway between 1 and 3, right?
Never mind.
Okay. What do these two numbers become?
And then.
And then 2.5, awesome. Alright, we're doing a right-hand side estimate, which means that for every chunk, Jackson, you did your own, so all of your corrections are actually on your paper. There you go. Yeah. Okay, so if we're doing a right-hand side interval, that means we have four chunks, 1, 2, 3, and 4. If we're doing right-hand side, that means this chunk is defined by 1.5, this chunk is defined by 2, this chunk is defined by 2.5, and this chunk is defined by 3. That's what right-hand side means. You guys cool with that? Now, what's the base of every chunk? 0.5, there you go. So if it's 0.5, what's the height of every chunk? Careful.
You have to plug it in.
Careful. I heard it.
Plug it in.
Plug it in. Plug it in where?
Right in the point.
To the function, yeah, to the function. Alright, so if we plug it into the function, good morning, morning. If we plug it into the function, we basically run 1.5 up until it hits the function, right? And then we run 2 up until it hits the function. We're plugging this x in to get out the corresponding y, which defines the height of the chunk.
So we just plug in all of it?
Yeah, so for the first chunk, second chunk, third chunk, and fourth chunk, we have area equals base times height. Well, the base is 0.5 for all of them. And the height is
9 minus.
Point, sorry, yeah, 1.5, 9 minus 1.5 squared is, I have no idea what it is.
6.75.
6.75. So the area for that, boy, that's ugly. Multiple colors going on there, that's cool. 6.75, 3.3 something.
3.75?
3.375.
Oh, never, yeah.
So then the next one, base times height, so for the second chunk, we're using 2, so 9 minus 2 squared is 9 minus 4 is 5. 0.5 times 5 is 2.5, and you just do this on and on and on until you solve your areas, and that's the estimate. Hi.
Hello.
Who else asked for this one? Logan, you asked for these. Does this make sense now?
It does make sense. So, I was doing something completely different. I wasn't drawing it out like you were.
Yeah, I like the number line because it's helpful to visualize it this way. What if I were doing the left-hand side estimate? What would the four numbers be that I would use then?
Wouldn't it be 3.5? 4, 4.5, and 5.
Well, if I'm going from 1 to 3 and I'm doing left-hand side estimates, what is the left-hand side of this chunk?
0.5.
1.
1.1.
What's the left-hand side of this chunk? Logan.
1.5.
Left-hand side of this chunk.
2.
Left-hand side of this chunk.
2.5.
So notice that you, instead of using the right-hand side of each chunk, now you're using the left-hand side to define the height. The base is still the same. Kirby? Awesome. Fuel. Here, guys, is that u prime and u to the n can switch places. So what we have here is u to the n times u prime, or what u prime should be, right? That's just the place of u prime. Is that possible? Can we do that?
Yeah.
What's 4 times 3?
12.
So what's 3 times 4?
12.
Okay, so can we move things around when they're multiplied together?
Yeah, you just gotta not be stupid about it.
All right, so u to the n times u is u prime is the same as u prime times u to the n. So again, this is not necessarily u prime, this is just where it should be. So which integral are we working with? 1, 2, 3, or 4?
2.
2, why 2?
Because we have u to the n and u prime, and our...
Let's take
exponent is not negative 1.
Why isn't it number 1?
Because we have more than just 1.
Yeah. It's a lot more complicated than just some x to the n power or several x's to the n powers. Why isn't it number 3?
You got no e?
No e. Why isn't it number 4?
No, negative 1.
This is not negative 1. So by default, this has to be integral number 2. Okay? So then my u is x cubed minus 3x squared. My u prime is 3x squared minus 6x. We have x squared minus 2x. We want 3x squared minus 6x. What do we multiply it by?
3.
3. So I'm going to do that, and while I'm doing that, I'm going to shift this over to make it easier to see everything that I'm about to do. So I've got negative 1 to 2.
Yeah, man. Oh, man. She's going ham.
Tell me what I just did.
Hold on. Let me look at the whole thing.
Okay.
You have to distribute.
Yeah. So I put my U to the end in the place where I'm most comfortable with it, right? I just moved it over. And the stuff that I'm manipulating, I moved out front. Where'd the one-third come from?
It came from the division, the division rule.
Yeah, I needed the three on the numerator, so I kept it, and I picked up the three on the denominator and stuck a one on top to hold it down.
Yeah, something like that.
Hold it, well, it has to stay on the denominator, so you gotta put something on top, right? Otherwise, it'll just flow right back up to the surface. Hold it down. All right, so now what? Do I have what I want?
Yes.
What's my integral?
It is.
One-third goes along for the ride. What do I do, guys?
Cubed minus 3x squared to the second power. Wait, you already distributed.
No, not second power. N plus one.
Fourth.
And we're going from negative one to two. Brittany.
I know. I did it, and then I figured it out. That's the only thing that I got wrong.
I figured it out. You made it squared instead of to the fourth.
Yeah, because I minus three minus one. I don't know why.
Okay.
You got it, Lou.
Why isn't an absolute thing?
Wait, what?
That's an absolute, like.
No, it's not an absolute value. This is a command. So my command before this was integrate with respect to x. Now my command is plug negative 1 and 2 in.
Oh, that's good.
So if you look at your tattoo, Eli, on the very bottom of bottom right hand, okay, just grab Madison like it belongs to you. It's cool. So if you look at the very bottom right hand side of the tattoo, that's the process. You've integrated. Now you're at this point. This is Eli.
I would still listen.
It's okay. Look at the tattoo. So now you've got big F, which is your integral, from A to B. So now the next step
is to tell me. B to A.
Right, you do F of B minus F of A, right, Logan? Is that what
you're saying? Yeah, you plug him in. So the first one would be the one-third, that entire equation.
I'm going to make this 1/12 because it's easier for me to see.
Yep.
So I'm going to do 4 cubed minus 3 times... No, wait, not 4.
Yeah, I was like, what are you doing? It should be negative 1.
2 cubed minus 3 times 2 squared.
Oh, yeah, the 2 first because of B and then A.
Minus.
And then it's the negative
1. Negative 1 cubed minus 3 times negative 1 quantity squared. All to the 4th power over 12.
Now, So, kind of like... Yep, okay, I figured it out. Never mind.
And for consistency, I guess I can put that in there.
The top value is always the B value.
So now it's all about watching your signs, Madison. That was a little help. Okay, talk to me.
I'm just taking it all in.
You're taking it all in? Okay, awesome. All right, so what's 2 cubed, guys? 2 times 2 is 4 times 2 is
6.
8. So then we have 2 squared is 4 times 3 is 12. So 8 minus 12 is? So now we have negative 4 to the 4th over 12. That's what this all becomes. Minus, I'm going to leave my brackets in for consistency. What's negative 1 times negative 1? Times negative 1 again. So hold on to that. That's a negative 1. Negative 1 squared is? Positive 1 times negative 3. So what's negative 3 plus negative 1?
Negative 4.
So now we have negative 4 to the 4th over 12. And who gives a crap what those answers are? Because what is the same thing minus itself?
0.
0. Your answer is 0, guys.
Do you really?
Yeah, it's super cool.
How do you feel?
Yeah.
Awesome. Who asked for this one?
Not me.
Seriously.
You?
Not me.
And Destiny Valor. Okay. Yeah.
We have this is the
straight in. You mean like right here? You start plugging in the 2 and 3 and 1? No, you have to integrate. You have to follow its directions. It is literally commanding you. plug in negative 1 and 2 in the right order, not home. It's always this one minus this one. That's what that bottom right-hand side of your tattoo is for. It's very, very, very bottom.
Okay.
Once you integrate it, no matter what it is, then you plug in the top one minus the bottom. Questions? Comments, fears? Eli, your hand twitched.
I realize.
You're good?
Yeah.
You sure?
I tweak.
Yeah.
It's okay. No, I got it.
We're all tweakers on the inside.
You're all tweakers.
So what's up with this label?
You guys are hilarious. That's what it is.
We just added an extra row, man.
Bro, you're
it was
in
funny.
He doesn't know that he's in all.
He don't care.
Pitching.
God bless
you.
You could join us.
No, no, no. I woke up, smelled my car, I was gone. My car got to put my backpack in my trunk.
Okay,
total?
Number 53.
Is that total?
Yeah.
Depreciation.
Depreciation! Yay, depreciation!
Okay, wait.
Depreciation actually is. When you buy a hard good, I don't care if it's a car, a building, a piece of machinery, a piece of equipment, if you work in a doctor's office and you buy a new laser, if you work in a, you buy a new power or like a flexible drill, if you work in a dentist's office, if you're an esthetician and you buy an IPL so that you can lie to your people and tell them it's an actual laser, so they get rid of their unwanted hair a lot slower so you can charge a lot more. Yeah, those people are liars. Total liars. IPL is not laser, guys. FYI, if you're doing like laser therapy on your hairs, not the same thing. Do your research. Caveat emptor. Anyway, any hard good, any piece of equipment is bought at a price when T equals zero. That's what this is. And over time, it depreciates. And it usually depreciates linearly, although with cars, y'all know it's not linear, right? It's exponential decay. Decays really fast at first, and then it slows down in its value over time, right? So that it decays a little bit slower as time goes on. But this is essentially what depreciation is. After a certain amount of time, your equipment is valueless. You with me?
Yes.
So a lot of companies sell it at some point to recover some of the value, and then they start over. That's kind of what a lease is for a car. Mm-hmm. You lease a car, it depreciates in value, but then they take it back after 3 years before it's lost all of its value, and then they resell it again. So they mark it up and sell it again so they can recover some of the depreciation on the car. That's how depreciation works. You guys with me?
Yes.
Okay, so this is kind of what we're about to do. So the rate of depreciation of a building is given by E prime of T. Is 3,000 times 20 minus T. 3,000 times 20 minus T in dollars. Is that in dollars?
Yes.
Yeah, where 0 is less than or equal to T is less than or equal to 20. What do you think this 20 represents, guys, on that chart over there? Yeah, this is the point where it's valueless. You guys with me? Travel time. Have your test. Who's got the? You got it. So then it goes to this one. Actually, who's next? So awesome.
I'll be in there.
So he's got the key.
Oh.
Awesome. All right. So that 20 represents that time where this building is valueless. Use the graph to find the total depreciation of the building over the first 10 years. Oh, there was a graph. Oh, looky! Look how pretty! Oh my God, it's exactly what I said. So this equals 20, here's 10, and here's the depreciation over the first 10 years. All right, so how do we do that? So forget the function for a second. This is essentially a rectangle and a triangle. What's the area of a rectangle?
It's like...
Base times height.
What's the area of a rectangle or a triangle? Oh my God. Okay, so what's the base of this?
Zero.
10. What's the distance between 0 and 10, people? 10. Okay, what's the height of this? How do we determine the height? We plug 10 into what?
I think we're getting
the function. So what's 20 minus 10? And what's 3,000 times 10?
30,000.
So this is 30,000. Okay. All right. When t equals 0, what's 3,000 times 20? Well, 3,000 times 2 is 6,000. Add a 0 is 60,000. So this is 60,000 up here.
When it's 0?
When t equals 0, yeah.
You said 60.
Look at that.
You're missing a 0.
Plug it in. Oh, I am missing a 0. Brittany.
Dang it.
You're missing a 0 on your 30,000 too.
Oh, crap. Who said that? What's your last name? Is it a D? No, that's the other. That's your other. N.
So, like, that's
the option. Oh, it's 30,000?
Yeah. Okay. So now what? What's the area of this rectangle? 30,000 times 10 is... 300,000. And the area of this triangle is 10 times 30,000 is 300,000 divided by 2 is 150,000. So this area is 450,000, isn't it?
Yes.
Total.
Oh, total. Okay.
Yeah. So you got 300,000 for this chunk and 150,000 for this chunk. Okay? So we can do this. Yeah, Brittany.
I did it way differently.
Oh, no. This is part A. Part A,
okay.
We have to do
this. Is part A. Area. Part B wants you to do it using
like the
calculus.
Okay.
Yep. So part A wants you to do it using calculus. So this is A. We did it using the calculus. Now part B wants you to do it
the math way.
Using the integral. So depreciation over the first 10 years. So we're going from 0 to 10. I'm going to go ahead and distribute that 3,000 and make it 60,000 minus 3,000 t. And I'm doing this with respect to t. Why? You can either do it this way where you have a function. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I just distributed it. I was like, wait. And I'm going from 0 to 10, aren't I? Because that's what the graph says. So now what? Which integral is this? 1, 2, 3, or 4?
1.
What's the integral?
It's like
60,000 t minus 3,000 t squared over 2 from 0 to 10. You guys with me? Okay. So what's 3,000 divided by 2?
3,000.
Oh wait, no.
I'm just gonna go like put my head in an oven now. 3,000 times 2 is
6,000.
6,000.
Yes, you said divided by 2. You said divided.
Or divided by 2, sorry. 1,500. Jordan.
What? Can you do this problem without distributing the 3,000?
Yes, you can, but what's your u prime here?
It's negative 1.
Negative 1.
Yeah, so then you have to multiply and divide by negative 1. And
yeah, I did it that way too.
Yeah, kind of a pain in the neck. In this case, for me, it's easier to just distribute it and do integral number 1.
Yeah,
but that'll get you the right answer too. You just have more negatives to deal with.
That makes sense. That makes sense.
Okay, so now I'm going to make that a 1,500, Eli.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Now we plug in Chuck. What's 60,000 times 10?
600.
Minus 15,000 times 100 is, or 1,500 times 100 is 150,000. So 600,000 minus 150,000 is what?
450,000.
Right, and if we plug zero into this as well, these are gonna both go to zero, right? So we'll still end up with our 450,000. I'll get out of your way.
So it's the same number. That's crazy. It's like six, like crazy six.
I don't even know what to do with my hands here.
You just leave them, you know.
Just leave them?
Yeah.
Just wave them around.
Yeah, you could do the Michael Jackson moonwalk if you want. Too much better. Yeah, that was about to shoot recording.
I never get ready for
this. I'm going to tip my little hat. No. I'm on a carpet anyway. You can't do the moonwalk on a carpet. Not really.
Voice of the awesome.
Yeah, we do. Yeah, we do. I had long hair and I went to short hair. Oh my god, very
And all right, you guys, let's tackle 13.3. For context, this is the.
We're almost done.
This is our fourth of four lectures. So after today, we have three new lectures left.
Yay. This is fabulous. All right. So wait, we're gonna restart this.
Welcome back to my YouTube channel.
Please visit for all the calculus of
please like and subscribe.
Yeah, exactly.
Professor,
somehow.
You're already up.
Well, what if I slept in?
Then it's too late.
Yeah. That's not true.
I came and took the test. I was 45
because
minutes.
Because it was a test of 90
minutes. Are you 5 minutes away?
Yeah.
Jesus. You have no excuse, dude. Some people get up and like commute an hour into town.
Yeah, I commute 45 minutes every morning from Arvada.
Yeah, I live by the airport. So
you live by the airport? Oh, that's awful.
So like a fence.
Literally, bro.
You're forgetting a parenthesis on the function, that one. I should get extra credit. I'm just kidding. But you are missing a parenthesis. There was a day where I pretended to be straight. It wasn't a day. I pretended to be straight for 18 years.
That was kind of rough.
That escalated quickly.
Mike, that's me, right?
What?
That is not me.
Yes.
Do I really have to? Yep, I need to write every bit of that.
Yes, you do. Or, since you're recording it, Logan, don't write. Just watch.
No, I'm writing.
Okay.
Yeah.
So notice, I did this graphically. This area under F from A to B minus the area under G from A to B is the area between them. From A to B.
Got to.
How do you guys feel about that?
I feel good.
Make a letter?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's alphabet soup.
That was
calculus. It's calculus, it's differential equations, it's all our higher math. Oh, no, it gets better.
Who's on top?
F. F comes first.
So is that a mic like that?
I did. Whoever is on top comes first, guys.
Oh, my God.
Not, that's not just what.
Seriously, whoever is on top in that region is who comes first in the end.
Yeah, she's making a sexual comment.
You'll never forget it.
No, that's okay. That's like the time when I was being taught distribution for the simple algebraic equations, and my teacher called them boobs instead of loops. So I now always remember.
Whoever is higher in the region of interest is who goes first in the integral. So it's top minus bottom.
So far. Logan's taking it.
But you'll never forget it. And it literally is whoever's on top goes first. So now, let's do a practice problem. Okay. Just waiting for you because I need to get there eventually. Alright.
You got me there. You got me.
That's so nice.
Laughing, you're paying attention, so that's why I do it.
That's alright, man. That's alright, I'll take it.
No.
Jordan has to know my coming out story.
Every generation
likes
the invention.
Jordan has to know my coming out story.
They're like, we're the first ones ever to discover these amazing new things.
I mean, it's funny.
Thanks.
Yeah.
My parents are Mormon and from the South.
Oh.
My mom was a cop and my dad was a Marine.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and my stepdad.
How do I find this area, people's?
Michigan.
Oh.
Yeah, it happens. They're good though. It took some time.
With respect to what, Junior? From what to what, Junior? Go forth and conquer, people.
You were like so quick at drawing these graphs.
Yeah,
the Jesus.
I know, I tried to make mine look cute.
Like, mine just look like garbage.
I don't know what to tell you. I have practice. That's
you know,
why I'm like, don't write. Just listen. You've got the writing. Yeah,
but I need to,
you
like,
need to?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, I definitely took a GRE. Okay, wait, I lied. My teacher definitely let me pass geometry by memorizing the first 100 digits of pi.
I'm seriously delighted that you guys feel comfortable enough to just stream of consciousness out into the void.
You're welcome.
Yeah, it's awesome. You're welcome. It's good.
Mm-hmm. I thought so, too.
It's good.
Oh, my Lanta.
Yeah.
You
said that a lot. Your mom.
She said, go forth and conquer my little chickies.
Which integral is this?
This is number one.
Why is it number one?
Because you're working with one part to the whole. You don't have the two different thingies. Whatever. Term.
What?
Thank you.
That's called a tart?
A tart? No.
What was the word you said?
Term?
Term.
Term.
I said I don't know. I was saying the thingy. I had no idea what I was talking about.
What's my integral, guys?
The integral would be, it would be, frick. Damn, she's doing decimals in her head.
I'm doing it slowly.
A lot faster than I would. plug and chug.
Yes, ma'am.
Me too.
I feel like that's one of the most universal math terms ever.
Yeah.
Plug and chugs.
Fill and chill.
That's a new one for me.
Whatever floats your boat, guys.
Dude, we're just so punny today.
We're so punny.
Is Spanish your first language?
Yes.
So that's awesome. How long did it take you to learn English? Or was it incorporated? Are you from this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh my God.
And then did you go to a Bible school?
Mm-hmm. But like the teacher had to learn Spanish.
I cannot stress to you guys how important watching your signs is now, especially if your function on the bottom contains multiple terms. What was one of the biggest mistakes I see when you guys subtract cost? You forget to change all the damn signs.
Yeah, that.
So don't forget to change all the signs on your bottom function. I cannot stress to you how important that is. Right. One little sign. So be careful, be diligent, be meticulous. Alright.
Be clean.
How do you guys feel about this one?
Do you see this?
Hunky dory.
It's not so bad, right?
It's whatever.
It's cool. Now, let's up the ante a little bit.
No.
Damn it. I know you guys are ready for this, Eli. Is that a hand or a stretch?
It was a hand, but
what's up?
Maddie might have answered my question. Where did that 2 times 2 come from? Mm.
So we had a 1/2 out front, so the integral of x becomes x squared over 2. So we'll get a 1/2 times 2 on the bottom, or a 1/2 times x squared over 2. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Good math. All right. Now, sometimes.
Oh my God, they would make such cute babies.
Who's on top switches halfway through.
One of them comes through.
What are you talking about? No, there's probably like only 4 people here actually. Everyone else is.
22? So everybody thinks I'm like.
Damn it, I need to draw this.
How many can you draw that perfect DNA?
I know, see, can you draw
that
for me?
Is that perfect DNA? Perfect DNA.
Wow, that doesn't even look like
this. Actually, DNA looks like this.
Okay.
Then you do like.
It's like Bill Nye, probably.
Yeah, it's too early for that.
You guys don't know how interested I am in like so many things.
So you're into art?
I'm into art and into science. I'm into math. I'm into history, sociology, psychology.
Oh no.
Anthropology.
You sound just like me. You sound just like me.
You sound like the reason why I dropped out in the first place.
I love construction. I love engineering. Ooh. I'm fascinated by processes.
Prosthetics.
Yeah, I used to, but I don't have cable, so it's usually when I'm like up and drunk in a hotel room somewhere. And I have to be up late in the morning, so I stay up late at night and drink and watch crap like that.
Do you know how to drink wine?
All the TV shows and all the movies.
Champagne. Oh, That makes me happy. All right.
It's only on my.
It's probably illegal.
No.
How many regions do I have to integrate here, guys?
You have two.
I have two. What are my intersects?
Your intersects are definitely zero and then like two some other random points. But I can't tell you.
How do we determine them?
Something with those equations. I'm assuming you have to like do integrals. I don't know.
Okay. So you can do it one of two ways. You can do it graphically. So you graph the two functions in your calculator and then go to intercept, right? You guys ever used intercept in your calculator?
Yeah.
So you have function one, function two, and you just get near to the point you want and it'll converge to the solution. And then you do it again for this one and it'll converge to the solution. And you do it again for this one and it'll converge to the solution. So you can do it that way. Or you can do it algebraically. So here we go. Y equals
That's
x.
That's what I was talking about.
X squared. Yeah. But it's also equal to 2x at those 3 points. Right? Literally the functions equal each other at those 3 points.
And then you solve for x.
Yeah.
Or whatever. Yeah. Sweet, so I was right. No, something. Wow. Wow. I know you are.
What multiplies to negative 2 and adds to negative 1? It's
10%. I don't know, but it's got to
go. Negative 2 and 1.
Good, negative 2 and 1.
Did you just factor?
0 equals x. 0 equals x minus 2. And 0 equals x plus 1. So now, I have x equals 0, x equals 2. And x equals negative 1. So this is 0. Here's negative 1. And here's 2. Not to scale.
Oops.
Okay. Oh, the braces?
Question?
Yeah, answer.
You factored.
I did.
Okay.
I sure did. So
you did
the first thing I did was I recognized that all of these contain an x, so I yanked it out. Because I don't factor cubics, I factor quadratics. Right? And then the next step is I recognize what multiplies to negative 2 and adds to negative 1. And oh my god, I hope you guys can hear me. What multiplies to negative 2 and what adds to negative 1? Negative 2 and 1 multiply to negative 2 and add to negative 1. So those become my next terms. And then I set all of these equal to 0. Why do I do that?
Because that's a common point for all of them.
Yeah. But even more important, if any one of these terms goes to 0, what is the value?
0.
Good. So I can say if any one of these terms goes to 0, that makes the statement true. So that's why we solve for it in that manner. Okay?
Well then. Good to know.
So now what?
Now you do the that thingy.
The what? The thing?
Yeah.
The thing?
Because you're trying to find the area of those. Okay, so look, you got the two lines. Now you're trying to find the area. So now you have to do the definite interval thing where you get the b minus a and all that crap.
Yeah.
Now I just have to figure out how to set it up, but hold on.
You don't have to figure it out. Look at this first region. Who's on top?
Who's on top? Definitely y equals 2x.
No, careful.
No.
Holy crap. Oh, yeah, you're right. Sorry, I was.
So
Jesus,
from negative 1 to 0, because we read from left to right, this is going to be x cubed minus x squared minus 2x with respect to x.
So this is integral 1.
Yep.
What about this region? Who's on top?
2x
comes first. Plus the integral from what to what, guys? 0 to 2. 2x minus x cubed plus x squared with respect to x.
Wow.
Wait a second.
I'll let you think about that.
Hold on.
Oh, yes.
I didn't even finish writing.
Wait, we're adding it this time?
Wait, what?
We're adding it this time?
No.
Is that a
subtract?
No.
Because you're adding the areas.
Oh, so
right?
This is different than the other thing we did.
So this plus comes from adding the two areas together. And this was top minus bottom, this is top minus bottom. These are gonna look different because the function on person, the function on top is different, okay? For each of the regions.
Oh.
We don't discriminate.
I know what you're doing.
Does that make sense? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm actually understanding this.
Yeah. It's a very visual thing, the area between two curves. It really is.
Yes, but I mean, like, I'm actually getting the math part behind this, which is super weird, so I'm going with it.
Awesome. That's good.
We're just floating with it. Let's bust out another one. Let's keep this practice going.
I'll give you guys a second to play with this one, okay?
Oh, yeah. We have to solve now. And that's just a lot of math.
This one? So this is the top function, and then x cubed minus x squared is the bottom function. So when I subtract x cubed minus x squared, all the signs change. So remember what I said, when you subtract a function, you subtract all of it. So all the signs change on the second function. That's kind of like, remember the cost, I reminded you guys over and over and over and over and over again, change all the signs on cost when you do revenue minus cost. Oh, there's a reason why, and this is mainly it. Does that help? So if I do over here, x squared minus x cubed minus x squared, and I distribute that negative, I get x squared minus, or sorry, that's 2x. My apologies. So all the signs will change. Okay.
Every part of me hurts. Every part of me hurts today. Oh, Jesus, she does. That's not how she goes. So pretty much you have four functions. I know, she went so fast.
No, because of this. When you subtract a function, all the signs change. Oh my god, I lost my place. Okay, what? It's okay. Go ahead.
So,
what?
Oh, wait, no.
Where? Here?
Yeah.
This is function number one minus function number two. Top minus bottom. And here we have bottom minus top and all the signs, top minus bottom and all the bottom signs change.
Okay.
I know you guys.
Do you?
I do.
That's my middle name.
You seriously think my middle name is Chelsea? I'm not a stripper.
Okay.
Hey, I know plenty of nice strippers, and I also know plenty of nice Chelseas.
I know. I have a stripper squad myself. They're amazing. Okay. I love those people.
Let's not make, let's not assume that everyone named Bunny is a stripper and everyone named Candy is a stripper.
I mean, fair.
Yeah, I know.
Is that all one problem?
Yes.
Alright.
Welcome to doing hard work.
Okay, yeah.
Welcome to
Can you move a little bit to the left?
Please.
Thank you.
You can say please.
Yeah.
I did say
please. No, you didn't.
In my head, I did.
Why is that?
You guys, that this is not complicated, it is just
tedious
as anything. It's brain surgery on the board, but it's not difficult brain surgery. No one dies if you get a sign wrong.
Yes, they do.
No, they don't. don't forget this little negative here, guys. Reminder, 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 reminder. That changes everything. Yeah, so I have.
My notes are kind of crappy right now.
Oh, yeah.
You did the same thing I was thinking about doing. The common denominator. Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
And that's my answer, and it is right.
Yes.
No, it is, because I checked my book. And what really makes the difference here is that little negative right here. Little guy, right there.
I'm going to start practicing my algebra skills.
At this point, not algebra so much as multiplication. If you know how to do that. Multiplication, division, addition, subtraction. We're back to kindergarten here, guys. It's not kindergarten. It's elementary school. It's elementary math.
It's like fifth, sixth grade, yeah.
Yeah. All right, you guys. Let me give you a couple more minutes with this on the board, and then I've got to erase it and do another one. I know. How do you check your work?
You plug and chug. Put it in the calculator. Put it in the
function int. This guy plus function int this guy. And you can check your work pretty easily because this one isn't difficult to plug in. Okay. All right.
It's a solid point on the. It's a point on the vertical. No, it's not. It's a vertical line. Vertical line.
Vertical line at x equals 1. So this makes sense to graph, guys. You're gonna want to graph this one because it's gonna make a lot more sense if you graph it. Don't forget, x equals 1 is a vertical line. All right.
Okay. We're graphing.
I know you hate graphs.
X cubed plus 1. Okay, now we do the menu. It would be negative.
And
No, that's not what I want.
Okay, cool. I have it graphed.
Like, that's what it looks like.
Whoa. Mine looks a little different. Why?
Well, because this you can't graph.
This was just about to tell you.
This you can't graph. This x equals 1, they're not gonna allow you to do that. How many of you tried to put y equals 1 in your graphing calculator and try to graph it?
It worked on mine.
It spit out something up here.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's not y equals 1, it's x equals 1.
You're right.
It's a vertical line, you've got to put it in yourself.
Let me see if I can actually, hold on.
So now, do we have an area enclosed by these three things?
Yes.
Great, so what are we integrating from and to?
From, oh, okay.
Ow, biscuit.
Negative 1 to 1?
Yeah.
We're going from, how do you know it's negative 1? Who said that?
Carlton.
Oh, I cheated.
It's Carlton.
Carlton. Oh, you didn't cheat. You didn't cheat. Tell us how you did it.
Well, it just said 1 on here, so.
Bless you. Excuse me.
Kind of sneaky.
She's allergic to my bullshit, so.
Can you guys possibly find the intersect of these two functions?
It's almost as bad as Eli's. Yeah.
By
I'm just like.
Calculate intersect. Function 1, function 2. Blah, blah, blah. So give that a shot, because you're going to need to know how to do this for the test.
Hold on.
Just make them equal each other, right?
Yes. Whoa, what am I doing? That's not what I meant. Whatever. A cake lady.
Okay, actually, my graphing calculator does allow me to graph the x equals 1.
It does?
Yeah. So, do you want me to show you?
Yeah.
Okay. Under equation, it says you can do like y equals mx plus b or x equals c or whatever.
Nice.
Yep.
I know why it's, you want to know why it equals x equals negative 1?
What was that?
You said x equals negative 1 is the answer, but you want to know why.
Right here?
Yeah. Just make them equal and then just...
How do you do it on
yeah,
the
calculator? You can either do it graphically or you can do it algebraically the way Jordan
yeah, you
did
get,
that first. Hang on just a second for me. Alex.
Yeah.
Shh. There's Alex. Oh. Yeah, you can find the intersect that way. Brittany.
How do you get it on... How did you find negative 1 on the calculator?
The negative 1 on the calculator? So once you've got your graph, so you're on your graph, I want you to go to second calculate, which is above trace.
Second.
Go down to intersect.
Oh, yeah.
So do we first type in on this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It's not going to know what you're thinking. You have to tell it. It's a dumb box.
It's negative 1.
It's
negative 1. Great. So who's on top?
I mean, x cubed plus 1.
And who's on the bottom?
Negative x minus 1.
And we're going from what to what?
Negative 1 to 0.
With respect to what? How did I get x plus 1 here? Yeah, I subtracted my second function. Top minus bottom, these signs are going to change. So now I can simplify this. And integrate.
So you click second now.
Arrow down to intersect.
That's what I thought.
And it's going to give you a little flashing cursor. And it's going to say first function, second function, guess. And you're going to say, yeah, I want you to guess. And it's going to converge to the solution.
It says no sign change.
What?
It says error, no sign change.
Yeah, I think my calculator is in program.
There's also something on the screen.
Let me see what your calculator says. What the what?
That's what I'm
saying. Hey, quit.
I'm excited.
Okay, so let me see your graph. Okay. I'm gonna adjust your window first of all. I'm gonna go to the standard.
Yes.
Oh my god, you're fine.
Yeah, I'll be there next meeting, the phone will be.
If I could let us check.
I have a color to add.
Okay, I'm trying to see, this is should work.
I'm gonna turn it off.
Yeah.
X is plus one, negative X minus one.
What did I say about this?
It's not white, but I just, X equals one, so there's that sucker.
Better go find that.
There's one. Here's the two. And then your X equals one is a vertical line, which your calculator cannot do. So then you go try second calculator.
Second calculator.
Arrow down to intersect. Who else is struggling with their calculator?
Jordan.
So Jordan's trying to fix my side. Awesome, thank you, Jordan. Don't laugh. Alright. Still a little confused. What are you struggling with, Junior? Hang on just a sec.
Alright, I think Madison broke.
Was that the integral?
Yeah. No, we didn't. We did top minus bottom, so if we subtract this, what's gonna happen to the signs? That's right. Okay, so it's still consistent. I promise. It's still consistent.
Oh, that's one.
No, it was in there.
No.
Hiding. So you got another one. Three, six. I didn't. Well, just in case, I don't know if there's, oh no, it looks like you got one, so just throw it on. Yep, nice. Two, six. Justin, what was your question?
Same one?
Yeah.
How to change the signs? It's top line is bottom. Good. How do you guys feel about these?
Not bad.
These are?
It's whatever.
It's whatever.
Okay. Zach was on a stretcher, right? That's a stretch. How do you feel about these?
This keeps moving better.
Better? Good. How about the rest of you? My quiet ones.
Somebody said it was like doing laundry.
I got my calculator here.
Do you want to borrow mine to play around for a couple minutes?
I'm good.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have an Android or an iPhone?
No.
It's gonna dilute.
I'll get it. Okay. I gotta go get my car.
It's already been diluted.
Yeah,
and
then they told it didn't dilute. There's no way. I'm looking at all of you now, Alejandro. Brittany,
was that your answer, the equal sign?
No.
No, you can integrate that on your own.
Okay,
you're a smart girl.
Yeah, right. After you integrate it, then you do the A and the B, and then subtract the 9 and the 4.
Right,
you're
happy?
Yeah.
Lauren, you're good? Edward? Omar? DJ? Amara? I know everybody now. This class I've got down. The other class, forget it.
What's my name?
Forget it. You guys are much more talking than the other class, but I've got some good idea now. So. Good, I'm happy. All right, you ready for your homework?
Sure.
I know what it is, because I don't have a book.
So we do homework 13.3, 1 through 5 on.
Does somebody have a textbook?
1 through 5 every
other one. Anyone? Nobody.
Don't
you dare!
Does what?
She didn't raise her hand, guys. I sold her out because I saw
this. What happened?
Sorry. Oh, you don't bring your textbook.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I totally sold her out.
So can we really do 13.3, 1 through 5 odd?
No.
Come on. You have to admit, that was a pretty solid homework choice.
1 through 12 odd.
Okay, that's not bad.
Then.
Yep, it's not bad.
No. It's like five problems, like not even.
No, that's not all of it. That's six problems.
Okay.
Problems.
Yeah, but six problems is going to take like 8 pages.
13 through 21, every other odd. So that's 13, 17, 21.
Is that the new music? Then we're done.
You know, you guys, I tried.
What is this? What is 1 through 12? What does that say?
Yeah, that's fine. No applications this time.
Yes! You love us!
They're all average functions, and I didn't teach you guys that, and I don't expect you to.
Oh my god.
Just say that.